Adelaide is building Australia's most expensive road. But why here? Not Sydney, not Melbourne, but Adelaide. The answer? It's the last major city in the country without a motorway you can drive from end to end without hitting a single red light. The city's north-south corridor aims to change that, and right now, all eyes are on the River Torrens to Darlington section, a critical missing link that will finally give Adelaide the continuous motorway it's been promised for decades. Before we hit the road on this mega motorway, make sure to signal your support and subscribe for more projects reshaping our cities. Adelaide might be known for its easy lifestyle, but on the roads, things are far from smooth. While Sydney, Melbourne, Brisbane, and Perth all have continuous motorways cutting through their cities, Adelaide drivers still crawl along South Road, one of the most congested stretches in the country. Locals know this pain too well. South Road is infamous. It is the main north-south artery through the city, but also the bottleneck that slows everything down. Trucks and cars get stuck here, delivery schedules are stretched, and people heading home or to work waste time sitting still. The South Australian government decided decades ago that this could not be the future. Enter the north-south corridor. Piece by piece, sections of the motorway have already been built. The Northern Expressway and Northern Connector link Adelaide to Gawler. The South Road Superway bypasses industrial suburbs, and the Southern Expressway now connects fully to Old Norlunga. But even after all that construction, one vital piece is still missing. The final obstacle is a 10.5-kilometre stretch between the River Torrens and Darlington, the only section where drivers still face 21 traffic lights. Until it's fixed, Adelaide's dream of a fully connected non-stop motorway can't be realised. That's why the state is pouring $15.4 billion Australian into completing it, one of the costliest road projects in the nation's history. The goal is simple: remove the bottleneck that's held Adelaide back for decades. Once finished, the corridor is expected to cut up to 40 minutes off a north-south trip during peak hours, improve safety by eliminating dangerous intersections, and create faster freight links to the port and industrial hubs. For Adelaide's economy, this isn't just about shorter commutes, it's about keeping goods moving efficiently and businesses competitive. Everything now depends on this last stage, the River Torrens to Darlington link, and how it reshapes the way Adelaide moves. But how do you close a gap that has held back an entire city for decades? The answer is tunnels. Instead of carving through Adelaide's suburbs, engineers are tunnelling beneath them, creating one of the most ambitious infrastructure projects South Australia has ever attempted. The River Torrens to Darlington, or T2D, will finally close the gap in the north-south corridor. Around 60% of the route will be underground, with twin tunnels stretching nearly 6 kilometres each, running beneath homes, businesses, and even heritage sites. Building them requires advanced engineering, precise planning, and thousands of workers coordinating around the clock. So why tunnels? Because the alternative would have been devastating, bulldozing straight through residential neighbourhoods and demolishing schools and landmarks. Going underground protected those communities, but it also sent costs soaring. Every dollar of the $15.4 billion budget reflects the complexity of tunnelling deep under a built-up city. Each tunnel will carry 3 lanes of traffic and require massive tunnel-boring machines, each the size of a small building, to grind through layers of rock and soil. Crews will handle ventilation, water management, and emergency access. While above ground, new interchanges and lowered sections will keep traffic flowing smoothly. When it's complete, the T2D won't just remove stop-and-go congestion. It will also support thousands of jobs and pump billions into South Australia's economy during construction. The project is expected to wrap up by 2031, marking the end of decades of planning and the start of a truly connected Adelaide. Every mega project comes with a price, and in Adelaide's case, that price is more than just money. Yes, the Torrens to Darlington section alone costs $15.4 billion, but the real story is what it takes to make a project of this scale happen in the middle of a living city. Let's start with property acquisition. To carve out space for tunnels, surface interchanges, and lowered motorways, the government had to acquire hundreds of properties along South Road. Homes, small businesses, and even community hubs have been cleared. For families, it meant they had to pack up and leave behind entire lives. For local shop owners, it meant shutting down or relocating. Then there is construction itself. The North-South corridor is not being built out in the desert. It is slicing through Adelaide's busiest suburbs. That means years of detours, temporary closures, and noise. Anyone who drives through the project zones already knows that traffic jams don't disappear during construction. They multiply. And with tunnelling crews working 24/7, residents nearby live with constant vibrations, dust, and the hum of heavy machinery. Politically, the corridor has become a balancing act. Governments promise faster commutes, job creation, and economic growth. But critics point to the cost blowouts, the drawn-out timelines, and the toll on communities. The project has already been revised multiple times. Designs change as engineers, planners, and environmental experts try to balance efficiency with impact. And every change comes with another delay, another budget climb, and yes, another tunnel design. Still, the economic case is hard to ignore. The government argues that finishing the corridor will deliver tens of billions in benefits over its lifespan. By connecting freight more efficiently to Port Adelaide and industrial hubs, businesses will save on transport costs. By removing stop-and-go traffic, drivers save time, fuel, and frustration. And by reducing conflict points, the motorway should cut accidents, which themselves cost billions nationally every year. But the question is, how much pain is Adelaide willing to take now in order to unlock those long-term gains? Because the price of progress is not just billions of dollars here, it is years of upheaval and the daily grind of living inside a construction zone. And yet, when the last tunnel opens and the final light disappears, Adelaide will no longer be the odd city out. Personally, I think it's a huge step forward. Costly, sure. But if it actually delivers smoother traffic and better freight routes, it might just be worth every dollar. What about you? Do you think this project will transform Adelaide, or is it just too much money for too little benefit? And if you want to see more stories about the world's biggest architecture, design, and construction projects, make sure to subscribe to Design Zip. There's plenty more on the way. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.